Welcome to the Battle Drill Devotional Podcast with Captain Rob Westwood Payne.
Today is Wednesday, the 17th of May. This week on Battle Drill Devotionals, we reflect on the awesome privilege of being God's people. Today we turn to 1 Peter chapter 2 and verses 4 to 10. And we're reading from the New Living Translation. Living stones for God's house. You are coming to Christ, who is the living cornerstone of God's temple. He was rejected by people, but he was chosen by God for great honor. And you are living stones that God is building into his spiritual temple. What's more, you are his holy priests. Through the mediation of Jesus Christ, you offer spiritual sacrifices that please God. As the scriptures say, I am placing a cornerstone in Jerusalem, chosen for great honor, and anyone who trusts in him will never be disgraced. Yes, you who trust him recognize the honor God has given him. But for those who reject him, the stone that the builders rejected has now become the cornerstone. And he is the stone that makes people stumble, the rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they do not obey God's word, and so they meet the fate that was planned for them. But you are not like that, for you are a chosen people. You are royal priests, a holy nation, God's very own possession. As a result, you can show others the goodness of God, for he called you out of the darkness into his wonderful light. Once you had no identity as a people, now you are God's people. Once you received no mercy, now you have received God's mercy. Amen. What is the church? Many people think of the church as a building. People speak of the local church or the church down the road, and what's in their mind when they say that is a building. Peter portrays the church not as a building, but as the living, spiritual temple of God. Richard Rohr has mapped out the journey of many Christian denominations. A man or woman sees a unique way of doing and being church and starts something. Think William and Catherine Booth and their calling to the unchurched working classes in the Victorian slums of the East End of London. If this new thing succeeds, then it grows into a movement as people join the cause and feel part of something that is dynamic, creative, and purposeful. That is how Peter describes the church in his letter. Unfortunately, at this point, human nature often takes over. We mechanize, we add structure, we organize, we create routine. Suddenly, the dynamic, free, and unstructured movement becomes weighed down by rules and regulations, strangled by bureaucracy. Sadly, as more people realize they are no longer participants in a movement, but supporters of a machine, the machine becomes a monument, or worse than that, a mausoleum. The machine becomes the object of our focus and attention. What becomes most important in our context is that we love the Salvation Army itself. It's essential that we belong to it rather than whether we belong to God or not. It's essential that we and others are taking part in its activities, whatever they are, rather than ensuring that our activities are actually part of God's work. All is not lost. there are many Salvationists around the world who realize that this isn't what we're about. Salvationists who realize that our calling is to be living stones, not a dead mausoleum. So let's work with them. When we do so, God will multiply our efforts, and together we can build a beautiful house for God. As you think through these challenging thoughts today, you might want to use these questions to help you. Is your core or church or denomination a man or woman, a movement, a machine, a monument, or even worse, a mausoleum? And what part can you play to ensure that it's made of living stones? I hope to see you soon for another Battle Drill.
If you would like to subscribe to Captain Rob's Battle Drill devotional, wherever you choose to listen to podcasts, or if you'd like to receive them direct to your inbox, head to www.equippinghispeople.com/devotional and follow the instructions.